Hi everyone. As I discussed in my video, The Most Insidious Form of Climate Change Denial, one of the solutions to the climate crisis is a shorter work week. This is something I've become very passionate about, speaking from experience. I've been overworked, I've been unemployed, and I've worked part-time. I'll be sharing a lot of personal anecdotes in this video, but to fully embrace the idea of a 3-day work week, it's important to understand the concept of degrowth. I highly recommend watching my video and reading Jason Hickel's book, Less is More. We've been indoctrinated to think of economics in a very narrow-minded way, and we need to step out of this neoliberal framework entirely. Capitalists claim that a 3-day work week is infeasible and too pie in the sky. But they fail to acknowledge that what is truly infeasible is eternal economic growth. There are numerous benefits to a 3-day work week, including healthier and happier people and a lower environmental footprint. Faced with time scarcity, people gravitate towards environmentally unfriendly meal delivery services and prepackaged food. Think about it. If you're swamped with work, you're less likely to reach for greens that you have to wash and de-stem yourself, and more likely to grab the pre-washed greens in the plastic package. And you're less likely to actually eat those greens if you have less time to plan and cook meals. Busy schedules make eating out more tempting, even when we have food in the fridge, thus generating more food waste. I can't think of a more poignant example than meal delivery services. Like, what an indictment of our society that we don't have time for the most basic human task of properly feeding ourselves. It's time to rethink this system. The 40-hour work week is unsustainable and inhumane. A few months ago, I had a 30-minute Lyft ride where the driver and I got into a semi-heated debate on this topic. It all started when we passed a homeless man, and he said, "I don't mean to get political, but I saw a homeless person the other day with a sign that said, anything helps." And I asked him, "If anything helps, have you tried a job?" I calmly explained why this was super fucked up, and he let me speak, but then responded, "Well, I'll tell ya, I think that is bullshit." And then went on and on about how people these days are so entitled, and how he worked his ass off 80 hours a week to pay for law school, and then became the CEO of a successful tech company. He said he could retire if he wanted to, but he chooses to work. I really missed the opportunity to say, "Well, I think that is bullshit. Like, why the hell are you driving for Lyft?" People are so brainwashed by hustle culture that they think that busting their ass working 80 hours a week is a badge of honor. And you don't deserve basic necessities like food or housing unless you work your ass off. I'm sorry, sir, but what if I'd like to keep my ass? What if I want to work a healthy amount? Apparently that makes me lazy and entitled. Needless to say, I didn't leave a tip. Conservatives scoff at the idea of a 4-day work week, let alone a 3-day work week, because they believe that it encourages laziness. So let's talk about laziness. I recently read the book Laziness Does Not Exist by Devin Price, where they argued that the concept of laziness is essentially capitalist propaganda. They made a compelling case that a lot of the things we attribute to laziness are actually the result of something else. For example, homelessness is not an epidemic of laziness, as many people believe. Homelessness is the result of addiction, mental illness, and misfortune in an individualistic society. According to Devin Price, people who haven't experienced homelessness, like my Lyft driver, moralize the decisions of poor people, perhaps to comfort themselves about the injustices of the world. For many, it's easier to think homeless people are responsible for their suffering than it is to acknowledge the situational factors. And when you don't fully understand a person's context, it's easy to impose abstract, rigid expectations on their behavior. But they're already doing the best they can. I've known homeless people who have worked full-time jobs, who devoted themselves to the care of other people in their communities. A lot of homeless people have to navigate bureaucracies constantly, interfacing with social workers, caseworkers, police officers, shelter staff, Medicaid staff, and a slew of charities, both well-meaning and condescending. It's a lot of fucking work to be homeless. And when a homeless or poor person runs out of steam and makes a bad decision, there's a damn good reason for it. Another example is the desire to do nothing all day. This is often viewed as laziness, when in reality it's a sign of burnout or depression. Fat people are often regarded as lazy, but this is based on prejudice. Extra weight is the result of consuming extra calories. It has nothing to do with work ethic. I highly recommend this book, or if you want the TLDR, read this article. To paraphrase the key takeaway, if a person's behavior doesn't make sense to you, if you look at their action or inaction and see only laziness, you are missing key details. There is always an explanation other than inherent laziness. Now let's talk about productivity. Productivity, to a certain extent, is healthy as accomplishment gives us a sense of fulfillment. But a hyper-obsession with productivity is detrimental. Studies show that given more time to complete a task, people are less productive. Studies also show that overworking leads to illness. Personally, I can attest to both of these findings. For a brief period after college, I was fun employed, living in my parents' basement. I thought I would use that time to write. But with all the time in the world, I had writer's block and didn't accomplish anything. Then I moved back to my college town for a yoga teacher training, where I worked 3 jobs to save up to move to Colorado. And in that time, I somehow managed to crank out a 100-page manuscript. But my health suffered because I had my first major anxiety attack. When I moved to Colorado, I started canvassing for working 5 days a week was very manageable because I only worked like 6-hour shifts, and I had very decent benefits, including paid time off. After a few years though, I decided to start this channel. And if you're not aware, making videos is a lot of fucking work. Right before the pandemic hit, I was experiencing such severe burnout that I had an anxiety attack on top of a freaking mountain. I told my boss I needed a week off, which she approved. And then that week turned into 9 months off because I was eventually laid off. The beginning of the pandemic was a huge relief to me. I could focus solely on YouTube and have time to relax. But not long into quarantine, I realized that I didn't have the motivation to post more than once a week. So I ended up sticking to the same upload schedule. 6 months into quarantine, I developed the worst anxiety I've ever had. Moral of the story is, neither extreme is good. Being unemployed or self-employed leaves me feeling unmotivated. I need some sort of schedule, some structure. And being overworked leaves me feeling exhausted. Both are a recipe for anxiety. Eventually, it came time to look for a job. I decided for the sake of my mental health to work 3 days a week. And I am so grateful I was able to find a job with flexibility. And of course, the privilege of being able to afford to work part-time. I started canvassing again, and it improved my mental health dramatically. For a few reasons. Number one, social interaction. Two, it was good for my ego to do something I was good at. Three, it felt good to fight for a good cause.
Why do you rich fucking white people insist on seeing every socio-political conflict through the myopic lens of your own self-actualization? This isn't about you.
Anyway, number four. Working 3 days a week was not too hot, not too cold, but just right. I found that the days I actually did work, I worked my entire shift and didn't slack off. Amazing. And there's data to back this up. People are more productive when they have extra time off for 2 reasons. One, ample time off allows them to recharge. And two, the psychological phenomenon known as Parkinson's Law. Parkinson's Law is the theory that work expands so as to fill the time which is available for its completion. In other words, if someone is given a week to complete a task that should really only take them a day to finish, they will often end up unnecessarily stretching out the task, so it will take them the whole week to complete it. Relating to my own work, in the beginning I was held to the same quota as full-timers, but I only had 3 days to meet it. Had I worked full-time, I wouldn't have worked as hard in my first 3 days, knowing I had 2 extra days to make quota. Although studies suggest that people could produce the same level of output working 4 days a week instead of 5, few could do so in 3 days. That's why those arguing for a shorter work week from the position that it improves efficiency and productivity advocate for a 4-day work week. But I'm advocating for a 3-day work week because the whole idea of degrowth is for output to drop. Like, we can't keep producing more and more. Our planet can't handle it. However, I recently started a new job selling solar, and I decided to work 4 days a week. I'm okay with the renewable energy sector growing, at least for now. And so far, it's going really well. My mental health has improved a lot, so I can handle the extra day. But I know that if I had to work 5 days a week on top of YouTube, I would lose my mind again. I would start to slack off, and despite clocking more hours, my performance would drop. To share a bit of personal context, I graduated college without debt, and my husband makes decent money. But I also want to stress that adopting a minimalist lifestyle and living below my means contributed to my ability to take a pay cut this past summer. I know there are people in the same position of privilege as me who think they can't work part-time, but in reality, they simply prioritize other things. I think if enough people in positions of privilege start prioritizing time off, we'll start to see a cultural shift. People who have been conditioned by society to trade their time for more money will start to envy our wealth of time and want to trade money for more time off. This isn't the most appropriate fable for a largely vegan audience, but the point still stands. The industrialist was horrified to find the fisherman lying beside his boat smoking a pipe. "Why aren't you fishing?" said the industrialist. "Because I've caught enough fish for the day." "Why don't you catch some more?" "What would I do then?" "Earn more money. Then you could have a motor fixed to your boat and go into deeper waters and catch more fish. That would bring you money to buy nylon nets, so more fish, more money. Soon you would have enough to buy 2 boats, even a fleet of boats. Then you could be rich like me. What would I do then? Then you could sit back and enjoy life. What do you think I'm doing now?" If more of us took this to heart, we could lower our collective carbon footprint significantly. Unfortunately, working part-time is currently not an option for most people, even those who could afford it. My husband can't work part-time as an engineer, at least not at this stage of his career. Same goes for my brother, who's a welder. And here's the thing. If you count YouTube and domestic labor like cooking, cleaning, and grocery shopping, I work over 40 hours a week. Ideally, I would love to work 3 days a week and share household labor with my husband. But it's only fair for me to do more of the housework and work a fourth day to help save for our future, considering he's working over 50 hours a week. Which brings me to my next point, which is that the 40-hour work week was fought for by unionists during a time when women stayed home in the kitchen. In other words, the men working 40-hour weeks didn't have to do any domestic labor. We've come a long way in terms of women's rights, but in terms of workers' rights, we've regressed. Wages have stagnated, and we've gone from being able to support a family on a single income to requiring a double income. The modern 40-hour work week doesn't account for domestic work, which is work. It's inaccurate. This puts a strain on relationships. My coworker and I were talking about this, and he was telling me that his girlfriend works as a vet tech, and since they were understaffed, she was clocking like 60 hours a week. He was working 40 hours and battling mental health issues. Neither of them had the time or energy to cook or clean, but since she was working more hours and her job was slightly more emotionally draining, it was kind of on him to pick up the slack, which freaking sucks. Many people point out that the modern work week is unnatural to our species. I'm not one to romanticize nature. Hunter-gatherers may have had more leisure time, but they didn't live very long. The 3-day work week is not about returning to how things should be. It's about looking at our current system and asking, is this fair, or does this make sense? Technological advances that could have been used to reduce working hours were instead used to ramp up production and increase profits. And this extra stuff is not being produced to serve humanity. It's produced to serve the elite at the expense of everyone else. A prime example would be Amazon warehouses throwing out hundreds of thousands of unsold items per week, including unused iPads and MacBook Pros, because it's cheaper to do so than hold them in storage or donate them. All of that labor to produce all of those goods, what was it for? Would this happen in a truly democratic society? I don't think so. And then there's the argument put forward by author David Graeber that many professional managerial class jobs in today's society are meaningless. His essay on the phenomenon of bullshit jobs is both fascinating and perplexing. Why would businesses pay people to perform pointless tasks? Doesn't that go against the logic of capitalism? He argues that the answer clearly isn't economic. It's moral and political. The ruling class has figured out that a happy and productive population with free time on their hands is a mortal danger. Think of what happened when this even began to be approximated in the 60s. And on the other hand, the feeling that work is a moral value in itself, and that anyone not willing to submit themselves to some kind of intense work discipline for most of their waking hours deserves nothing, is extraordinarily convenient for them. If someone had designed a work regime perfectly suited to maintaining the power of finance capital, it's hard to see how they could have done a better job. Real productive workers are relentlessly squeezed and exploited. The remainder are divided between the terrorized stratum of the universally reviled unemployed and a larger stratum who are basically paid to do nothing in positions designed to make them identify with the perspectives and sensibilities of the ruling class, managers, administrators, etc., and particularly its financial avatars, but at the same time foster a simmering resentment against anyone whose work has clear and undeniable social value. Clearly, the system was never consciously designed. It emerged from almost a century of trial and error, but it is the only explanation for why, despite our technological capacities, we are not all working 3 to 4 hour days. Thank you so much for watching. I'm looking forward to reading all your comments down below. What has your experience been like as a worker? All right, peace out. Yo, how when me eat, them I wonder when me eat. When me tell them, say me no eat no fish, nah, no meat now. How when me eat, them I wonder when me yum. When me tell them, say that I'm a vegan, man. How when me eat, them I wonder when me eat. When me tell them.